They are dead because their heart is full of sin. That's why we want to consider some sins that pollute the heart and defile your heart and makes your heart not to be perfect. Ezekiel 36, verse 26. A new heart also will I give you. Why? Why the God is saying that He will give us a new heart? Does it mean that we don't have heart? Does it mean that He wants to, why is He saying that He wants to give us a new heart? Does it mean that He wants to give us double heart? Does it mean that He wants to add another heart to our heart? A new heart will I give you, and a new spirit will I put within you, and I will take away the stony heart out of your flesh, and I will give you an heart of flesh. Sin that defiles and pollutes the heart. When your heart is polluted, when your heart is being defiled, it will become a stony heart. It will become a hardened heart. It will become a heart that no matter what people say, it will not even concern you. No matter how they preach, it will not touch you. You see, stone now. Is there any way that rain will fall and soak inside of a stone? That will be soaked. It will just soak outside. So there are some people that their heart is just hardened. It's just a stony heart that nothing can break into it. That's why God is telling us, God wants to assure us, God wants to inform us, God wants to make our understanding. He wants us to understand something that will harden the heart, that will pollute the heart, that will defile the heart, that will make your heart to be full of evil. Number one, it is a sin of pride. Pride defiles the heart. Pride destroys the heart. The Bible says pride goeth before destruction, and a haughty spirit before a fall. So we need to guard our heart. In Proverbs chapter 4, sin that pollutes and defiles our heart. Sin that pollutes your heart, that won't make your heart to be perfect. Sin that hinders your heart from being perfect. Sin that will harden your heart against the word of God. Sin that will make you not comfortable to hear the word of God. Sin that will make you to be comfortable with the state that you are. Proverbs chapter 4, verse 23. Keep thy heart with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. Keep your heart, guard your heart, protect your heart with all diligence. Why? For out of it are the issues of life. We know that our heart is our life. So we need to guard our heart. When something is a reasonable something, when something is important, when something is a precious thing, you need to guard that thing with all diligence. You need to secure that thing so that nothing will touch it. Even the way you used to hold a football, you will not hold football with care like the way you hold an egg. The way you hold egg, the way you preserve egg, you preserve it with all conscious. You preserve it with all care so that it will not fall from your hand and break. But you can even throw a football. You will not break, nothing will happen to you. You will not even tear yourself. So we should guard our heart like egg, so that it will not break in into pieces. We should guard our heart. That is what the King Solomon is telling us here. That we should guard our heart. We should keep our heart with all diligence, with all our strength. Why? Because out of it is the issues of life. Why? Because our heart is our life. So if you allow your heart to be polluted, if you allow sickness to affect your life, it will affect your body. If you allow your heart to be defiled with sin, it will defile the whole of your body. Proverbs chapter 16. Proverbs 16, 23. Proverbs 16:23, the heart of the wise teacheth his mouth, and addeth learning to his lips. The heart of the wise teacheth him wisdom, knowledge, addeth learning to his lips. But the heart of a foolish person didn't do so. The heart of a foolish person will also teach that person to do evil. Because all these evils that are happening, it comes from the heart. The sin people have been committed, it comes from the heart. So we should guard our heart. We should perfect our heart. We should keep our heart pure. Because out of it are the issues of life. Out of it are the issues of perfection. Out of it are the issues of our righteousness. Matthew chapter 12. Matthew chapter 12, verse 34. Sin that pollute and defile our heart against perfection. Sin that pollute our heart, that will not allow our heart to be perfect. Matthew chapter 12, verse 34. O generation of vipers, how can ye, being evil, speak good things? For out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. We have learned about tongue today, our Sunday school. About tongue. The way we speak, it comes from the heart. The way we talk to people, it comes from our heart. The way we answer people, it comes from our heart. The way we take matter, it comes from our heart. So if your heart is polluted, if your heart is defiled, it will also generate it out from your mouth with what you speak. Number two, it is a sin of covetousness. You want to have this thing that this person has, you want to have it by all means. Just like competition. You want to have it too. Why is it that it's only this person that is having this? I must have my own too, covetousness. It comes from the heart. Number three, you have a sin of lust. Lust after a woman, lust after a man, to commit sin with him or her, to sleep with the person. That sin generated from the heart. That sin comes from the heart. It is a sin that defiles the heart. It is a sin that pollutes the heart. It is a sin that will not allow your heart to be perfect. It is a sin that will not allow you to be perfect. It is a sin that will hinder you to be perfect. It is a sin that will hinder you to move forward in love, to be moving higher in the spirit. Sin of lust, it defiles the heart. Number four, it is a sin of envy. Envy. Why is it that it's only this person that's having this? You are angry because you see your neighbor is prospering. You are not happy because you see this person, he knows more than you. You are not happy because this person has money more than you. He has properties more than you. is envy. It is a sin that generated from the heart and pollute your heart against perfection. Number five, sin of gluttony. Gluttony means indulgence of the flesh. You want to satisfy your flesh. Anything that your heart thinks that do this, you want to do it. You satisfy your flesh. You satisfy yourself. Even though the things is against the word of God, you don't care. What you want to do, what you know is to satisfy your body. Gluttony is the sin of the heart. Number six, sin of anger. Sin of anger. You need to be very careful because angry. The Bible says we should not follow angry man. Proverbs 24, verse 21. Proverbs 24, verse 21. He said, my son, fear thou the Lord and the king, and mingle not with them that are given to change. Who are those people that are given to change? That the Bible says that we should not mingle ourselves with them. Who are those people that the Bible is saying that we should not interfere with them? That's in Proverbs 22, verse 24. Proverbs 22, 24. Make no friendship with an angry man, and with a furious man thou shalt not go. Why? 25. Lest thou learn his ways and get a snare to thy soul. The Bible is saying that we should not follow, we should not have friendship with the angry person, with the angry woman, with the angry man, so that you will not learn his way, so that you too, you will not become an angry person too, so that you too, you will not learn the way the person is behaving, because like I said, the friend of a thief is also a thief. So the Bible is telling us that we should not follow them. And Ephesians chapter 4, verse 26. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 26. Anger is a sin that pollutes the heart. Be ye angry and sin not. Let not the sun go down upon your wrath. Neither give place to the devil. We have two types of anger or angry. The Bible is telling us that we should be angry, but we should not sin. And why is that? The Bible is also against anger. It is the way God created man. We have anger. It's possible that we will be angry based on what somebody do to you, based on what people react to you, based on what people take action, based on their own action to you. But we should not commit sin. You should not allow that anger to become sin. You should not keep that person, you should not keep that matter. If somebody offend you, you should not keep it in your mind and say, this person I don't forgive her. It has already resulted to sin. If a person slap you, although you didn't slap the person back, you must be angry. Say, why did this person slap you? That one is not a sin, but if you slap it back, it's a sin. If a person cheat you, you must be angry. But you will not react into sin. You need to forgive that person. That's what the Bible is saying. But an angry man, the sin of anger is the type of sin that you say you will not forgive this person. Peter asked a question like, Lord, how many times will I forgive my brother? Who offended me, I forgive him. If he forgive me, offend me, I still forgive him. Up to seven times, Jesus Christ now said, even, I'm not saying that only seven times, but seven times 70, or 70 times seven, it's also the same. 490 times. There's no way your brother, your people, your child, your children will himself can offend you up to 490 times in a day. So the Bible is telling us to forgive. No matter how that person offend you, forgive. But if you say, no, I'm not going to forgive, it has resulted to anger. That's why he's saying that let not the sun go down with your wrath. Somebody offend you in the morning, you still keep that matter till night. It's a sin. That's why the Bible is saying that we should flee away from anger. It's a sin that pollutes the heart. Number seven, it's a sin of sloth. Sloth means laziness, slowness in mindset, slowness in taking action. All these things generated from the heart. All this sin comes from the heart. Luke chapter 6, verse 45. Sin that polluted the heart, sin that defiles the heart against our perfection. A little sin, you may say, that pollute our heart from perfection. Luke chapter 6, verse 45. A good man out of the good treasure of his heart bringeth forth that which is good, and an evil man out of the evil treasure of his heart bringeth forth that which is evil. For of the abundance of the heart, his mouth speaketh. When somebody started talking evil against you, when somebody started speaking bad things against you, know that that person has evil mind, evil heart against you. Because what he is saying comes from his heart. What he is telling you now comes from his heart. What I am saying now comes from my heart. It didn't come from anybody's heart. So if I'm speaking evil, it shows that my heart is evil too. If I'm speaking good, it shows that my heart is pure. So also, if your heart is polluted, you will speak polluted things. We have different types of heart. You have different categories of heart. People have different types of heart. Although we have only one heart, but we have a kind of sin that hardens the heart, number one. We have a hardened and stony heart. A hardened and stony heart. A heart of stone. That we read from Ezekiel 36, verse 26. He said he will take away the stony heart away from us. He will give us a heart of flesh. Flesh, something can hold it easily. But you cannot hold it strong. Flesh means a heart of a born-again Christian. A heart that when he will listen to the word of God, he will say, God, forgive me my sin. Say, God, I beg, I know we'll do this sin again. But a heart of a stony heart, anything that you say, you know, concern them. Anything that you say, you know, the doctrine. A stony heart appears up to 35 times in the Bible that God warned us not to allow our heart to be a heart of stone, not to harden our heart. In Hebrews chapter 3, verse 7, you will see it there. What's about that? So all of us, we need the divine operation and circumcision of our heart. We pray to God if you have a hardened heart. If you have a stony heart, pray to God that God should remove it away from you. As he said in Ezekiel, that he will remove away the stony heart. So that he should give you a heart of flesh. A heart that something will touch you. A heart that you have feelings. A heart of a kidnapper, they don't have feelings. They can kill people, they don't have feelings. You don't even concern them. Number two, we have a doubting heart. Doubting or unstable heart. Doubting heart, unstable heart, double heart. The area of God, they are there. The area of the world, they are there. unstable is a sin. James chapter 4, verse 8. Double heart, unstable heart. James chapter 4, verse 8. He says, draw near to God, and he will draw near to you. Cleanse your hands, ye sinners, and purify your hearts, ye double-minded. So if you are here, your heart is double. You are serving God and you are still serving Satan. You are going to church and you are still going to have this. See, you should clean yourself. You should draw near to God. You should ask for forgiveness. To run for repentance. A person who has this kind of heart should pray to God so that God should transform him. Number three, you have a proud heart. A proud heart. A proud heart appears up to 7 times in the Bible. Heart of a pure, of a proud person. In Proverbs 16, verse 5. A proud heart. Proverbs 16, verse 5. He says, everyone that is proud in heart is an abomination to the Lord. Though hand join in hand, he shall not be unpunished. See now, person that has a proud heart, he shall not go unpunished. It is abomination in the sight of God. It will pollute you. It will not make you to be perfect in this year of perfection. If your heart, you have a heart of a proud, if you have a proud heart, it will pollute your perfection. Number four, you have a forward heart, a perverse heart, a subtle heart. In the Bible, this one appears 4 times. Proverbs chapter 17 verse 20. Proverbs 17 verse 20. He that had a forward heart findeth no good, and he that had a perverse tongue falleth into mischief. A forward heart, a subtle heart. It means a person that they want to prove that he is wise. That my own am wise. My own heart, I'm wise. I can commit sin today and come back and ask for forgiveness. God will forgive me. I can go tomorrow and still do it again. Still come and ask for forgiveness. Because I'm wise. Because the Bible says we ask anything, he will do for us. The Bible says we confess our sin, he will forgive us. So that heart. We should commit ourselves to God so that God should remove away all the stars of heart that we have. Number five, we have a covetous or overcharged heart. Luke chapter 21. Covetous or overcharged heart. Luke 21, verse 34. Covetous heart, overcharged heart. It even appears up to 7 times again in the Bible. That shows that God is serious to push us, to transform us, to perfect our heart. Luke 21, verse 34. He says, and take heed to yourselves, lest at any time your heart be overcharged with suffering and drunkenness and cares of this life, and so that day come upon you unaware. What is he saying here? He's telling us that we should be careful. Take heed means be caution, beware, be careful, so that don't allow your heart to overcharge. Even to charge self, it's okay. Talk less of overcharge. Don't allow your heart to charge with evil. Talk less yourself to allow you to overcharge with so many things and brokenness. Don't allow your heart to overcharge with evil, to overcharge with covetousness. You want to have this thing just the way people, you are just following after the world. You are following after the dressing of the world. You are following after the pattern of the world. You are following after the manner, the way people of the world behave. You want to behave like them. That is what the Bible says, that we should be careful so that our heart will not lead us into the way of the world. So that the day of the Lord, the time of rapture, will take us unaware. You should be careful. Number six, we have discouraged and frightened heart. Discouraged and frightened heart. Deuteronomy chapter 1. Discouraged and frightened heart. There are some people that they have one heart, they have a heart of discouragement. They have been praying to God, God heal me from this. And God seems to delay their answer. He just discouraged. He said, maybe I'm not born again. Or maybe God didn't remember me again. God has forgotten me. He just discouraged. And that's how your prayer will not answer. You must have faith, because the Bible says the just shall live by faith. Discouraged and frightened heart. If something happens like this, instead of you to pick courage, you just discouraged. You just confused. Deuteronomy chapter 1, verse 28. Whither shall we go up? And our brethren have discouraged our heart, saying, the people is greater and taller than we. The cities are great and walled up to heaven. And moreover, we have seen the sons of the Anakims there. It's telling us the story, what happened, the last story of the children of Israel when they were on the way going to the promised land. When Moses sent 12 spies to go and spy the land of Egypt, of Israel, the promised land. They now went there to spy the land. All these people, they know that God is with them. They lose the miracle that God has did on their way coming. They didn't forget the miracle of the Red Sea, that God divided the Red Sea. They passed through the Red Sea. Now that it's only these people, they got discouraged there. They have a big body. They are tall people. They can fight us. We cannot able to stand against them. Because their heart are already discouraged. So also, nowadays, some people, though they have been falling into serious problems and God delivered them from terrible problem, when a minor problem comes on their way, they just discouraged. Instead of them to remember what God did for them in the past and say, God, you are the one that did this thing to me in the past. So also, this challenge, you will also remove it away from me. I know that you will do it. I know that you will remove it away from me. I know that you are our creator. You are the one that created me. You are the one that created Satan. You have power over Satan. You have power over witchcraft. You have power over demons. You have power to command them, to subdue them. But their heart is just discouraged. They will not even pray again. They are just afraid of evil. They are afraid of witchcraft. And you are the one that God has been protecting for so many years. Why are you afraid today? Because your heart, your body allow discouragement on your heart. Discouragement can hinder you from going into your promised land. Discouragement can hinder your blessing. Discouragement can hinder your way of going to heaven. It can hinder your blessing. It can hinder your prosperity. It can hinder your destiny. It can hinder the plan of God in your way. Don't entertain discouragement. See that these 12 people, 10 out of them came with evil report, came with discouraged heart, came with frightened heart. Only Joshua and Caleb that say we are able. We are able because they know that God doesn't fail. They know that God used to guard them. They know that God used to keep them. is with them. God has promised that he will be with them. That's why they succeed to go into the promised land, Joshua and Caleb. But the remaining 10 people, they died on the way because of discouragement. Discouragement can make you to die before your time. So don't allow your heart to full of discouragement. Lastly, about the heart, we have the carnal heart. Carnal heart appear also up to 7 times. Carnal heart, Romans chapter 8, verse 6. Carnal heart, say heart of a person who is not born again. Heart of a sinner is still carnal. Is full of sin. Romans chapter 8, verse 6 and 7. Because the carnal mind is enmity against God. For it is not subject to the law of God, neither indeed can it be. So then, verse 6 and 7. Let me read verse 6. I just read from verse 7. For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritual minded is life and peace. Because the carnal man is enmity against God, for it is not subject to the law of God, neither indeed can be. Carnal man, carnal heart, is dead. When you are carnal, when you allow your heart to be carnal, that means you are a dead person. But to be spiritual minded is life and peace. Thank God. This is where the name of our ministry is. Comes from in the Bible, love and peace. So, if you are here, you have a carnal heart, that means you are not a member of love and peace. Remove away carnality from your heart and be spiritual. Allow your heart to be spiritual. Because a person who has a spiritual heart is a member of love and peace. According to this place, because a carnality is evil in the sight of God. Carnality is sin in the sight of God. So, God will not entertain carnality. People who have evil heart, it resorted to the following. That's A to Z, number one. Letter A. It makes their heart. You have unabiding, they are unabiding people. Oh, unable people. People who has this 7 evil heart, it makes them to become unable. Anything that they want to do, something that you can able to do it, but you can't do it again because of your heart. B, they are unbelieving people. It makes them to become it resorting to unbelief. When you tell them that, see what God wants to do for you, they didn't believe because of their heart. It resorted to unbelief. It may also resort to uncourage. It resorted to uncourage. They don't have any courage in them again. They are uncourageous people. They don't have courage again. They don't have mind to do something again. It resorted to undecided people. It will make them to anything that they have to do to make a decision, to change things. They can't make decision to transform their life. They can't make decision to transform their life. They can't make decision to follow God. They are undecided people. They are uneloquent people. They are not effective. They are uneffective people. Something that is supposed to be effective, they are not effective in it again. Because of their heart. It also results into unfruitfulness. They are unfruitful people. It results into unfruitfulness in them. They are not fruitful. Why? Because of their heart. It is also resulting to ungenuinity. They are ungenuine people. They are not genuine. They are not born again. Because of their heart. They are unhopeful people. They are unhappy people. They are unhelpful people. They can't help people. They don't have hope. They going to have unhappiness. They are uninterested people. Why? Things that you are telling them, they are not interested because their heart is hardened. Their heart is hard of stone. Their heart is a frightened heart. They are uninterested people. They are unjust people. They are not pure. They are not holy because of their heart. They are unkept people. Things that you tell them, they will not follow it. You are just wasting your time because of their heart, because of the kind of heart that they have. It makes them to resolve like that. They are unlearnable people. You will talk, they don't want to learn. They don't want to change. You are just wasting your time because of their heart. Their heart is full of pride. Their heart is full of subtlety. Their heart is full of stone. Their heart is hardened. So it resulted into that. Also, they are unmiserated people. Unmovable people. People that they don't want to change. People that no matter how you talk, they are not softened. They are not soft. They are very tough. It's because of their heart that resulted into these things. Another one, they are later in. They are unnaturous people. Unnamable people. People that you cannot nurture them. People that you cannot teach them the word of God. Because their heart has already hardened. It now resulted into that. It also resulted into unobedient people. Anything that you say, they will not obey. Anything that you talk, they will not obey. Because their heart has already hardened. They are unprofitable people. They don't show, they don't have any profit in the sight of God. They don't have profit in the church because they are not serious again. People that have this kind of heart makes them not to be serious. It now results into unprofit. They don't have any profit in the sight of God. They are unqualified people. They are all qualified people. They are not qualified to do the work of God. People that have a heart of stone, they are not qualified to serve God. They are not qualified to be workers. People that have a frightened and discouraged heart, they are not qualified to be a Christian. They are unqualified people. They are unreliable people. You cannot rely on them because they will change tomorrow. They will say, I will do this. Tomorrow, say, Pastor, I can't do it again. They will change. That's why the Bible says we should not mingle with them that are given to change. They are unreliable people. Later age, they are unstable people. Because their heart is unstable. They are not sincere. They are unsincere people too. They are not weak. They are not truthful. You cannot trust them. That they are unteachable people. You cannot teach them. Anything that you say, just because of their heart. You must first of all remove away the heart of stone in you before things will enter into your body, before you will change. Later you, they are unuseful people. Unuseful. Although they have the gift and then, but they are unuseful. Although they have the gift of tongue, they are unuseful. Although they have the gift to preach, but they are unuseful. Although they have the gift to sing praises, but they are unuseful. Although they have the gift, they are talented, but they are unuseful because of their heart. They are unuseful people. You cannot use them. God cannot even use them. Let them be, they are unvulnerable people. They are not valuable. They don't have value. God didn't value them. People that have a stony heart, God doesn't value them. People that have a stiff neck, God doesn't value them. You only value the one that their heart is pure. They are, they are unwilling people. If you say, I will need workers to do this thing, You don't have many minds to do it. They are not willing to do the work of God. They are not willing to be a workers. They are not willing to pray. They are not willing to serve God. They are not willing to sing chorus. They are not willing to sing praises to God. They are unwilling people. They are on X-axis people. They are on X-axis people. They are the people that doesn't, they don't even have value in the sight of God. They don't have value. They have gift, but they don't have value. Valueless, meaningless in the sight of God. Later, why? They are unyielded people. Anything that you say, they don't want to follow what you say. They are not yielding to what you are saying. They are following their own way. I have my own way. Let me behave the way I feel like. Let me do the way I like. They are unyielded people. Lastly, it has said they are unzealous people. They don't have the zeal of God in them. They don't have the zeal to serve God. They don't have the zeal to worship God. They don't have zeal to come to church. Coming to church is like a problem to them. It's like a burden to them. It's like they are wasting their time. They don't have zeal to come to church. Lastly, we pray in Matthew chapter 5 about the heart. Sin that pollutes and defiles heart perfection. Sin that defiles and pollutes heart perfection. Here now, we have considered the sin of the heart and the consequences of people who is living under these sins of the heart. Now, we are talking about the pure in heart. Matthew 5 verse 8, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. People that their heart is pure, people that their heart is not hardened, people that their heart is not defiled, people that their heart is not full, is not a stony heart, they will see God. That's their own blessing. But those that don't allow their heart to be pure, those that didn't purify their heart, they will not see God. Pray God will purify our heart from now in Jesus' name. Amen. This moment we are going to pray and commit our heart under the hands of the Lord, that the Lord should purify our heart, the Lord should transform our heart, the Lord should change our heart, the Lord should remove away stony heart, the heart of stone, God should remove it away from you. The hardened heart, the stony heart, it should remove it away from you. Pray and tell the Lord, remove away the stony heart. Remove away the hardened heart. Remove away the fracking heart. Remove away the forward heart. Remove away the softer heart. Remove away the carnal heart. Remove away the perverse heart. Remove them away. Remove them away. Remove away the double heart. Remove away the unstable heart. Pray and tell the Lord that God should remove them away. Every carnality in your heart, every defilement in your heart, that God should remove it away. Things that want to pollute your heart, every heart pollution, every heart pollution, every heart pollution, every heart defilement, every heart pollution, God should remove them away from you. God should remove them away from you. God should remove them away from you. Pray and tell the Lord. Pray and tell the Lord. In this year 2020, in this year of perfection, God should remove away every pollution, polluted sin, polluted sin, polluted sin. He should remove it away from your heart. He should purify your heart. Because the Bible says, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. That you want to see God, you will not go to hell. You will not go to hell. God should transform your heart. God should renew your heart. God should change your heart. God should give you a heart of flesh. Not a stony heart. Not a stony stubborn heart, not a heart of stone, not a heart of wickedness, not a heart of defilement. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Father, we thank you for your word that you have told us today about the heart, about the sin that pollute and defile heart perfection. Father, if any one of us here has been found with these sins, remove it away from them and push their heart in the name of Jesus. Father, every stony heart, every hardened heart, every unstable heart, every carnal heart, every fretting heart, every perverse heart, every heart of discouragement, every unstable and double-minded heart, Father, remove it away from us in the name of Jesus. Father, purify our heart. Help us, Lord, so that we will see you. You say you will give us a new heart. Therefore, Father, we are going back home with a new heart. We are going back home with a new heart. In the name of Jesus. Because we want to see you in the last day. We want to see you during the rapture. We want to see you when we die. Father, purify our heart from the day. In the name of Jesus. Let there be a change in our way. Let there be a change in our thought. Let there be a change in our action.